Okay, so longest Fibonacci sequence, right? So guys, in this question we have an input array we have to figure out, what is the length of longest Fibonacci sequence present in this array, right? One thing is also given in the question is the input array is strictly increasing, right? Strictly increasing. And what is strictly increasing? Strictly increasing means element must be greater than all its previous elements, right? So for example, as you guys can see here, 5. So 5 is greater than all its previous elements, right? And if you can say, let's say 3. 3 is greater than all its previous elements. So our input array is a strictly increasing sequence, right? And we need to figure out what is the length of longest possible Fibonacci sequence. The condition of Fibonacci sequence is nothing. If A, B, C is a Fibonacci sequence, then C must be equal to A plus B. So this is nothing but the condition for Fibonacci sequence or series, right? Okay. Now, let me tell you one or two things also. See, if a sequence has only one character, let's say A. There is only one character or one element present in a sequence, then we can say that this sequence is a Fibonacci sequence, right? And if a sequence, let's say, has only two elements, so this is also a Fibonacci sequence, right? But a sequence which has three or more element, then we need to check this Fibonacci condition, which is here. So this is a Fibonacci sequence, this is a Fibonacci sequence, but for this sequence to be a Fibonacci, C must be equal to A plus B. Similarly, if ABCD is a Fibonacci sequence, then C must be equal to A plus B and D must be equal to B plus C. Then only ABCD is a Fibonacci sequence, right? So, this is the basic of Fibonacci series or a sequence, right? Now the thing is how we will solve this problem, right? How we will solve this problem. To solve this problem, we will use a dynamic programming, right? So before dynamic programming, okay, let me write 2 here. Here it should be 2. Okay, now focus here, guys. Focus here. So what we are storing in this hash map, we are storing the values of our element and their indexes. So let's say 4 is present at index 3, 4 is present at index 3, so that's why we are storing this key value pair. 6 is present at index 5, so 6 is present at index 5, that's why we are storing this in that key value pair. So this is nothing, but its key is these values, and its values are these indexes, right? So first of all, we need to construct this hash map now. Now we will do what we will do. We will construct our 2D DP array, right? Now what is the meaning of one cell? What is the meaning of one cell of this DP array? So I also have written this. Yeah. So see, let's say this is one cell of this 2D matrix or 2D DP array. So what we are storing here is we are storing the length of longest Fibonacci sequence which has last two elements AI and AJ, where I and J are the index of that 2D matrix cell. Okay, don't confuse. See, let's say we are talking about this cell. So 2, 3. So value of I is 2, value of J is I, and this is J. J is 3. So why we are initially storing 2 here is we are assuming, let's say what we are storing here is basically we are storing a2 a3. So first of all, what is a2 a3? Element present at index 2 and index 3 is 3, 4. Okay, so it's 3, 4. So what we are storing here is we are storing the length of longest Fibonacci sequence which has last two elements 3 and 4, right? So this is what we are storing here is, we are storing here the length of longest Fibonacci sequence which has last two elements 3 comma 4. So initially we are storing here 2 only, right? I will tell you why we are initially storing 2, okay? So I hope the meaning of cell of this 2D matrix is clear to you, right? Okay. Now why we are storing 2 here? See, let's again come to this cell 2 comma 3, right? So 2 comma 3. So initially we are assuming that there is only there is a sequence which has last two element 3 comma 4. So we can assume that at least two elements of this Fibonacci sequence is present. So if at least two element is present, then we can say that length of Fibonacci sequence is at least it should be 2, right? So that's why we are storing only 2 here. Is we will upgrade its value later, but initially we are assuming, see, if the sequence has last two elements, that it must have at least 2 elements. So if the sequence has 2 elements, then we can say that minimum length its length can be 2, right? Okay, now how we will update its length? See, let me rough this. Okay, so let's just make 2 pointers. Say this is a I pointer and this is a J pointer. Using this IJ pointer, what we will do, we will check all the possible pairs, and we will check from this pair this Fibonacci condition, right? Now let's say this is a I pointer, this is a J pointer. See, and we are talking about 0 comma 1, that is 0 comma 1, this cell. Okay, see, so 1 and 2, the value present at these pointers is 1 and 2. Now we will check this condition. Is 1 plus 2 is present in our hash map? 1 plus 2 is what? 1 plus 2 is 3. And 3 is fortunately present in our hash map, right? 3 is present at index number 2. Now what that means is, we were assuming that 1 and 2 is the last two elements, but we have found one more element, which is 3. Now this is our Fibonacci sequence, right? Now what we can say, the Fibonacci sequence which has last two element 2 comma 3 has length 3. Again, listen guys, we can say through this condition the sequence which is present, the sequence which has last two element 2 comma 3 has length 3. Now what we had stored for this sequence 2 comma 3, we will come to this cell, and see what we were storing here is, we were storing here 2. I was talking about this cell. Why I was storing 2 here? See, we were saying that I and J is 1 and 2, that means this 2. So initially we had assumed that Fibonacci sequence which has last two element 2 comma 3 has length equal to 2, but through this condition we had find that the Fibonacci sequence which has last two element has length equal to 3, right? So that's why we should update its value, right? We should update its value. So now how we will update its value? We will increment this by 1, that is 2 plus 1, and store here. So we will increment it by 1 and store here. Okay, so let me rough this and we will store 3 here. Fine. We will not touch this cell, its value will remain same, right? Now what we will do, we will increment the value of j. Now what we will do, we will increment the value of j. So let me also erase this. Okay, so if we increment the value of j, so j will come here. So now 0, 2. So we were now at this cell. So now again we will check, 1 plus 3 is present. 1 plus 3 is what? 4. So yes, 4 is present. 4 is present at index number 3. 4 is present at index number 3. So what we will do, we had find a sequence this. So now what we will do, we will update the value for this cell, right? So 3, 4 is for this is this, right? So 2, 3 is this, 2, 3 is this. So why we had stored 2 here is we were assuming that only 2 elements, that is 3, 4, is present in this Fibonacci sequence. But now we had find a Fibonacci sequence which is 1, 3, 4, that means its length should be 3. So we also should update its value. So we'll update it by 1, increment this cell value by 1 and we will store it here. Okay, so we'll store 3. And similarly, guys, we will do for all the ij possible pairs, and at finally, if you do this for all the possible pairs and you will check all the possible pairs and check its Fibonacci condition, then finally your DP array will look something like this, right? Your DP array will look something like this. And once if you iterate over all the elements, then you will find its maximum value, right? So its maximum value for this case is 5, that is this one. So why this 5? This 5 means 1, 2, 3. If you closely look the test case, this 5 means we're talking about this sequence, this Fibonacci sequence. So we just need to we don't need to actually print this sequence. We just need to print the length of longest Fibonacci sequence. So we will simply return this 5, right? So now what is the time and space complexity for this problem? Okay, so the time complexity for this problem is n square. Now why n square? See, what we are doing here is we fixed a pointer I and now we are checking for all the j's except this, right? Now what we will do, we will increment I by 1 and we will again check all the j. Now we'll again increment it and we'll again all the j except this. So for this we need a nested loop, and for this we can say that the time complexity for this problem is, for this approach at least, we can say is big of n square, right? Now what is the space complexity for this problem? So the space complexity is again n square. Now why n square? See, for 8 elements we had constructed a 8 by 8 DP 2D array, right? So for n elements we have to create n by n DP array. So from this we can say that the space complexity for our problem should be big of n square, right? So the time and space both the complexity is big of n square. Now on the time for this code, the code of this problem, right? Okay, so code is here. So this is our input function, sorry, this is our given function, and this is our input 1D array, a strictly increasing sequence, right? So this is the corner case. If the array is null or the length of array is 0, then we should return 0. There is no Fibonacci sequence is present because there is no element, right? Now what we will do, we will create a DP array, 2D DP array of n by n. And now here what we are doing is we are creating a hash map which has key and value both are integers. Now, in this for loop, what we are doing is we are creating our hash map as I have showed you in the algorithm part, and we are initializing our 2D array, right? Now we'll come to this nested for loops where we are just checking if the condition of Fibonacci is satisfied. If satisfied, then just simply update your DP, array. And guys, see, this is the important line. This is the important line. This is how you need to update yourself. This is how you need to update yourself. Index is nothing but the values of hash maps, and ij, you all are aware, right? And you just need to update j comma index by 1 plus dp of I comma j, right? This is how you need to update your dp array, as I have showed you in algorithm part. And once you come out from this loop, your dp array is constructed, and you just need to find what is the maximum value of your dp array, right? And for this, you are using this for loops, right? For finding out the maximum value, and at finally, you just need to return the maximum value. Okay, so this is the code of this problem. Hope you guys understood this problem. Thank you so much for watching.